Okay, everybody, and welcome back to Kalat. My name is Reinhardt. I am trying to remember where the hell I am. It's been a couple of weeks since I played this last, so let's see. Let me get up to this camp zone real quick. That'll give me an idea. Okay. So it doesn't really tell you. How do you fast travel? How do you... Okay, put the damn map down, dude. Okay, so I'm right here. Cool. So, what I'm gonna do is head right here. And then run up this way, because I'm pretty sure there's some stuff in here I need to get. So, I'm not sure if this is gonna be the last episode. It might be the second to last. Okay. But we are making good progress, so I need to go... get my bearings here. I'm gonna get totally fucking lost. Just you wait. So we should be on track now. We're gonna go this way, kind of continue the story. If you remember last time, we essentially just found out a bunch of stuff. Because we're reliving through the pages, we find the events, what happens to the party before they leave. So like, who's the narrator? The narrator is that girl. And she's talking about, you know, all the events leading up to the night when everyone goes missing and dies. And then whoever Sean Bean is, and this is narrating to you about some stuff that happened or is happening or whatever. And then there's a third person who's someone who's gone straight off the fucking deep end and some stuff like that. So there's a lot going on. I'm pretty sure it never actually gives you an answer as to what exactly the game is about, but it's still fun because it's based on a true story. So let's move on and keep your eye out for any glowing footprints or just getting lost like I am. We're getting stuck on these stupid trails that you can't go up on. Okay, so you can't go up here. So I'm gonna have to go around. Yeah, because you come down from that side. Yeah, burnt out, destroyed looking forest. I bet that's what I'm looking for. Missed you, buddies. I missed you. Didn't miss you. You fucking dickhead. I have to go all the way back. That'd be such a pain. I have to go all the way back. But there's gotta be something in here that's like... Oh. I was like, oh look. But nope. That is not what I wanted. Hi, you. You wanna leave me alone? Leave me alone, please? Where are you? There's gotta be something here that's like clearly what I'm looking for. There is something. That'll give me an idea what I'm doing.
The weather today clearly got worse, just as our moods. We're all a little scared of what happened last night. There were even some suggestions of going back, but that was outvoted.
Well, you should have.
We set off at around 10 a.m., going the same Mansi trail as we did earlier. We encountered a small camp of a local hunter during our hike. We asked if he had hunted the other night, but he said no. He told us a story about a ghost prowling through the forest in the form of a bright fog. Obviously, this did not make us feel better. We kept on going forward. Today, the hike was slow and difficult. The visibility is close to zero. The temperature dropped to minus 24 centigrade. Around 4 p.m., we had to start looking for a place to set up a camp. We found a good spot on the verge of the forest, covered from the wind. As exhausted as we were, we began setting it up. We were too tired to dig up a hole for the campfire. We ate dinner in our tents. We had no strength for any discussions or thoughts. At night, I clearly heard someone walking around the tent. I heard them whispering my name. I do not want to talk about it with the rest of the group. They'll think I'm going crazy.
Well, you probably should have mentioned it. Because if you heard it, some other people might have heard it and they didn't want to see. God damn it. It's not where I thought it was. Okay. So, I need to go back in. Yeah, it should lead straight into whatever craziness I have to deal with now. Yeah, but if everyone in your group is kind of feeling like they're going crazy, don't want to talk about it, if you bring it up, someone might, like, agree with you. Okay, heading into the forest. Hey, buddy. I knew you were going to come say hi eventually. Oh, I see something. There we go. That's a good sign. And a bad one. Was there something in there? And no, no, there. That's clearly it.
I am an empty wreck, made in his image, but not a servant, obedient to one master. My body is a shell. And I am ready to absorb him. Now I see the plan. I see the magnitude of devastation. The Creator summons me. And I want to be his food. I am humming his tune. I am looking at the world through his eyes. I drink the blood of his enemies and taste the rotting bodies. I feel the sin sprouting under my skin. In my head. I hear them calling me. I hear the calling of the ones that through him have already found their eternal shelter. Free them, my lord! Free them and take me instead! Fulfill your revenge! At the hour of my death, an army of angels comes out from the orange light. Their song is made of one powerful. Their twisted faces, their black eyes drilling into my consciousness, They demand to finish the work. Oh, his presence is overcoming me. So poor and defenseless. What have they done to you? What harm? There is a place. You were there, and so was I. A huge gate, and the creator hidden behind it. Only those few who touched him could understand, but you could. You understood, and I understood through you.
Okay. He's getting worse. Fantastic. Let's see, where was that? Okay, so that's over here. Okay. 4396. Let's see. So I have... Yeah, okay. 45... So 45 something. 4584. So it's in that. So I have to go west. So it's in there. So I need to get over here. Which means from here I have to go south and east. $39.96. Oh, so it's actually just a little north of here. Okay. That's north west. Oh, shit. This might be what I was looking for. Yes, here we go. Yeah, this is it. I have an enemy around here somewhere. Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought. Oh, I see a campsite. Let's see if I can get up there. Hello. I like seeing these. Where am I now? Right here. Okay. So south into the forest. And then I should be close. Like, it's right around here. George, cut that shit out. You scared the shit out of me, man. Damn dog. Coming up and rubbing on me while I'm playing this. Maybe the ginormous tree in the center is what I'm looking for. Yeah, sounds like it.
My dear Vera, I'm spending my time in the Institute on long walks in the park. Only here I can find solace. Only in the shadows of the trees. My thoughts are peaceful when I see how the sun brushes the green leaves and the wind covers my face in a gentle, warm blow. The doctors say the worst is behind me. The breakdown was temporary. It's difficult for me to say what triggered this state. I know you'll never forgive me for what I've done. The tragedy that I've
murdered a bunch of people. Yeah.
Shall never find any justification or explanation. I can only cover it up with madness. But I am aware that this is a
pathetic excuse, and I'm not able to hide behind it. I take full responsibility for what happened. And I am prepared to be punished. The doctors, however, say I will probably not leave the Institute. You must know I would rather rot in prison 100 times for what I have done.
Did you murder her?
I have to confess. I tricked you. I knew you would never, ever want to hear what I have to say to you. That is why I sent my friend with this letter to your sister. And after a lot of persuasion, she agreed to read it to you. I thank her from the bottom of my heart for this. I'm ending this letter. I want to bore you no more. I love you and believe that someday, hopefully, I will be able to tell you all this in person. Luckily, my friend Anton is by my side at all times. He was the one that went to your sister. I hope this letter finds you both well and in good health. I wish you all the best. Forever yours, Vitaly.
Okie dokie. Okay. Good, good, good. So I got that. So I'm gonna head up here. So I need to go this way and get back out. Okay, confidential correspondence of Section 22 scientist. Doctor, confidential. I tested subject number blank. They did not show any supernatural skills. You had to make a mistake. Doctor, I agree with you. The second test did not show any skills. We may deem the experiment concluded and unsuccessful. The subject should be removed. We will prepare to transport to wherever. Destroy all documentation and correspondence. Huh. Oh, I am way off fucking track now. I am up here. I was supposed to be over here. every fucking time. Okay. Yeah, I'm on this lake thing. So, back down and this way. So I want to be over fucking here. Yeah, I'm not reading that. That's a little much, so you guys have at it. It's too bad. I'm going to have to bring it down a bit in post-production, but man, this game is loud. Like, if you play it at normal levels, they definitely make you regret having all the headphones in and stuff. No, that's... Okay, so I'm kind of up where I need to be now. Where's this trail?
We set off quite late today. I think everyone heard something at night, but they were afraid to admit it. I walked around the tents, but didn't notice any tracks. We didn't talk too much. We barely hiked 2.5 miles. We got the impression that something clearly changed around us. I felt someone was observing us, and I think the others had a similar feeling because they mentioned the hunter was heading in the same direction. We won't make it any further. I think we'll stay here.
Okay. Oh, man. That took a while. Okay, so I'm going to get back here, hopefully, and find out how to get to the last point. This is all I have is this one that's up here. And that's it. So, pray for me. Here we go. A 27-year-old is dead. The murderer mutilated her. Overnight, from Friday to Saturday, in a house in the center of Moscow, the body of 20-year-old, Victoria R. was found. The victim had multiple injuries as well as serious harm afflicted to the eyes. The perpetrator had not been caught yet. No traces of forcible entry were noted. Doors to the apartment as well as windows were closed from the inside. Victoria R. was the sister of 35-year-old Vera R., who was similarly injured by her partner. Yeah, Vichal's detective ruled out his connection to the crime committed due to him being locked up in a mental institution. Detectives do not rule out that Vital could have had a partner. Okay. So the dude murdered the girl, then went after her sister, which I'm assuming they're kind of hinting at that he has supernatural powers of some kind. It's kind of what I'm getting from everything. But when the tests came back, I'm assuming that's who they're talking about. So the tests came back negative, so they were saying maybe he doesn't, but he probably does. So he probably murdered all of the kids as well out in the woods, I'm guessing, from what they're saying. Because he doesn't actually have to be there in person to do it. Just a guess. Is it down here or is it up? So, that makes sense, because in his letter, he was in the insane asylum, and he said he wanted to send a letter to the girl to apologize, but he went through her sister, who was then attacked, I think, pretty sure, remember correctly. So, he can probably through, what do they call him? Anton? I think it's Anton. So Anton may be his manifestation of whatever. And that's who he can get to go do things. Aha. Oh, that's delightful.
It's dark. We escaped to the forest. Something tried to get in the tent. We heard strange sounds and an orange light. We are not going to escape from this. We are going to die. I don't know what's going on. I wanted to try, but I can't.
The fuck? Well, this is not good. Oh, come on. Let's find out. Yay, okay. Then we saw lights in the sky. A lot of lights. Orange spheres were hovering over the whole area, and it seemed the strange orange-red fog was coming out of every crack. We saw a man who came out of that light. I remember I started shouting, and he came up to him, my Anton. Okay, so, yeah, there is a lot going on here. Okay. Huh. I need to get north. Whole lot of story in this one. Okay, this should be a bridge and then north. Okay. Okay, I think we're finally getting there. Yeah, because now we're on this section. Okay, so this is the way we needed to go. Anything? Anything extra? So that's up into the mountain. Oh, I want to see what's over here. I want to find that page. Just love the story in this game. Aha. See, you must come here. Stop. Your agent has gone missing. Stop. The pass is off limits. Stop. We don't know what's going on. 9 people are dead. Before dying, the agent asked, "Where is Anton?" And I got an achievement for that, so I'm pretty sure that's all of... Okay, so that's all of the reports. That's everything. So, Anton is... Yeah, I'm assuming Anton's dead. The crazy guy keeps asking for about this guy. So the agent went nuts, killed all the people. And then just... I'm assuming he killed all the people and just went fucking crazy. Yes.
Are you coming to me?
Okay, so that's everything. Cool. Yeah. And that would not be easy to walk across because trees are not easy to walk across when they're freaking frozen. Or when they're not frozen, I mean, shit. Definitely can't run across that shit. That's so cool. I like how you can, like, focus on stuff. It's a nice touch for a game with a lot of depth to it. Oh, here we go. That looks like what we're looking for.
they call Post Office Box 5. I don't know where this is. I don't even know what year it is. They are not allowing anyone from the outside to have contact with us. They lock us up in cells, 4 in each. I saw dozens of cells like that. They talk about something they called Anomaly 7. Every day we undergo tests, research, tortures. I have seen how they kill people. I have seen terrible things. Write about it. Let the world know. They conduct the worst experiments possible. They have something that we call the Fear Chamber. There is no way to say what will happen to the person that ends up there. Some come back, but are no longer themselves. They are absent. Others are dragged out dead. Only few stay sane. I have seen a bright orange light, which spoke to me in demonic voices, and showed me things worse than any nightmare you can possibly dream. Sometimes people come out of there with broken bones, mutilated, crushed, irradiated, dismembered. I can't take it in anymore. Take away these images. There is a scientist amongst us. He said that during their sick experiments, they discovered something out of this world. They are trying to test it. The truth is that it is testing them. He told us that there are more places like this around the world, and there will come a day the gates of hell will open. You have to stop this. Destroy it. Destroy us. Kill us all. The center is governed by something that is called the Soviet Research Unit for Natural Phenomena. I have seen this on an ID card of the man that was interrogating me. He said we were prisoners, convicts, murderers, rapists, thieves. But that is not true. I have done nothing wrong. I hate them all. They call us subjects. No names, but subjects. I am Subject 73. I don't even remember my real name. I beg of you, please help us. Burn it all to the ground. If only this letter reached beyond the walls of the center. If only the guard who promised to take it has kept her promise. You have to do something. I swear by all that one holds sacred, you have to! My only cellmate, Anton, whispers in my ear that everything is going to be fine. That the orange light is singing in the voices of hundreds of angel choirs. Anton promised me that if I listen carefully to the singing, he will free me. Sometimes, however, I think that all of this does not exist. There is no prison. There are no bars. There are no doctors. There is no Anton. There's only this frightening, piercing orange light.
Okay, Act 3.
And so, we have reached the end. Have you understood your role in my plan? There are no random victims. And nobody is completely innocent. You may not agree. But when the gates to Section 22 open and the world will see true madness, you will understand that everything I had done was necessary.
Okay. Yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching. That was Kolat. Pretty good game. Well, yeah, and then until next time, keep being awesome.